Mr. Chair, kung yung ang simula nito yung ano ni Mayor Janice na presentation about Colonel Tolentino, there is a presence again, sir. Again, there is a presence of Tomasino Alidro na yesterday na mayroong manyanita yung katabi ni ano ni Congressman Teves. Every incidence of killing, sir, and there is a police involved, andun talaga yung presence lagi ni Tomasino Alidro. Yun lang po ang gusto kong sabihin, sir. Na Governor Digamo, although he is a governor, but the loyalty of the PNP, kasi wala naman siya maibigay na pera. Kaya dito yung ibang police, sir, na pinatawag natin, the reason sa mga ebidensya natin yung weekly na allowance.
Thank you. Mr. Henry Teves, sige, balik-balik yung pangalan niyang Tomasino Alidro na yan. Tapos kahapon pa yan nililink sa pangalan mo. Makontak mo ba yan siya para madala mo dito? Nasaan siya ngayon?
I will try to contact some members of his family and I will relay you to them, sir.
Please, this committee is asking your help.
Yes, sir.
So please bring that person dahil na very central, nagiging central figure siya dito sa investigation natin.
So siguro, sir, it will be proper if I can bring the invitation and I can send it to them personally.
Yeah, Kumusik, we are asking the help of kasi kilala man niya ito, he can contact the family. Gawa kayo ng invitation letter dyan. Willing ka magdala?
Yes, I will be down to have it received, sir.
Salamat, salamat. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Hindi, for today, for next hearing. Ay, hindi naman ngayon, ano oras na? Ha? Hanggang may buhay, hearing tayo. Walang katapusan ito. Baka mo... meron naman ko, ano? Merong binigay sa akin na picture. Hindi dapat si Bato de la Rosa ang mag-imbestiga sa kaso ni Teves. Tapos may picture kaming dalawa ni Teves, oh. 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 For the record, ha? May picture. Anybody can have a picture with me. Sa daming gusto magpapaselfie sa akin, pwede kayong magpapicture sa akin. Kahit sino. This is very malicious posting. But anyway, I have already addressed this issue yesterday. Walang prangkahin kita, Mr. Henry Teves. Kahit na lahat ng pera ninyo sa buong kayamanan nyo dyan, sa inyong sugar mill, sa inyong isabong, ipunin nyo yung lahat, bayaran nyo ako, hindi nyo ko mababayaran. Just to prove my point, just to emphasize my point, pasensya ka na kung nasabihan kita ngayon. Kasi mayroong mga insinuation dito na binabayad daw ako ni Arnie Teves. May picture pa nga, oh. Sabihin ko lang. Lahat ng kayamanan nyo, ipunin na niyo. Mag-attempt pa lang kayo, pupusasan ko na kayo.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Just to emphasize my point.
Yes.
Pasensya ka na. Kung ikaw nasabihan ko, wala si Arnie.
Nabuksan ko na yung accounts ko, sir. Malalaman nyo kung mayaman na po hindi.
Hindi, alam ko.
Saka wala pa akong picture sa'yo, sir. Hindi pa tayo nag-picture. Wala pa akong picture na ganyan sa'yo.
Hindi, kung hindi tayo nag-hearing, hindi kita nakita eh.
Yes, sir.
Narinig ko yung pangalan mo na merong Henry Pride Teves. Pero personally, hindi pa tayo nagkita, di ba? Hindi pa tayo nag-meet. So, ngayon lang, sa hearing tayo nag-meet. So, pasensya ka na. Basta pinalabas ko lang, mga malisyusong tao ito eh. Sabi ko nga, anyway, there's no use, defending myself. I have already said my piece. Go ahead, Senator Tolentino.
To expedite today's hearing, may we ask for the continuation of Mrs. Digamo's presentation and thereafter can we have finally the presentation coming from the Department of Justice. I think they're finished. Kaharap na natin yung folder sila. Ilang tanggal po ito. Marami pang folder. Para magkaroon po ng yugto, tuldok doon sa ibang mga na pag-usapan na. Mrs. Digamo, Mr. Chairman is raising her hand.
Yeah, yeah. Before I recognize Mayor Digamo, I would like to Attorney Mateo David of Anti-Money Laundering Council. Pasensya ka na, pinatawag kita dito para may executive session tayo. But sana makahintay ka. Ha? Okay lang sa'yo?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. Thank you very much for waiting for so long. You have the floor, Ms. Mayor Digamo.
Mr. Chair, it's okay for me if we can put off looking at the PowerPoint presentation on another date. But we would also like to have Attorney Ronel De Palubos invited to in the session to clarify a lot of things with him, along with Tomasino Aledro. Thank you, Mr. Chair. If we are running out of time, it's okay if we can put off. This can wait if we have a need to accommodate.
Tuloy mo lang.
Tuloy lang?
After you. Dito tayo. So, yung De Palubos daw. Comsec, imbitahan nyo yung De Palubos. Pahanap yan. Attorney De Palubos.
Okay.
Please continue, Mayor Digamo.
So, why are we all pushing to implicate the governor? Next slide, please. While the case of media man Dindo Generoso is slowly progressing, even if the suspected killers are already known, suspects who are linked to the to Congressman Tevez cases were dropped. Conspired and collaborated in coercing and intimidating Police Executive Master Sergeant Riuel Piñero to sign a prepared antedated affidavits sworn statement implicating Gov. Digamo and Mayor Janice Digamo as the mastermind in a crime of murder of Rex Cornelio. Can we have the sound for that presentation? The person on the video is the wife of Master Sergeant Riuel Piñero.
Atong sa ilang meeting dito sa Cebu nga, nakita niya na kamit niya po si Wiska, giingnan siya nga, motion to witness against ni Governor, anak ng case ni Rex Cornelio. So, alam siya nga, so may ako ikatuhan na din, ikaw, madahan mo, ako na ibalaan anak. Then, bisod na magtumok-tumok na sir, yung inan. Di ka kapalag, kinsa among the officers na dito ang directive in media. Basta, giingnan siya. No. Na mo'y hinungdan nga, mura siya nag-uol, nabalaka sa iyahang kinabuhi. Kaya naman yung iingan niya nga, wala kayo makuha niya mo. Amukang i-release, awal ka.
Papirmahon siya, ma'am?
Papirmahon siya, pa-execute'n siya ang affidavit na idiin si Gov na ano na kaso?
Ano na kaso?
Kaso ni Sergeant Rex Cornelio.
Mr. Sure, May.
Di siya mga panahon naman. Karat di siya mga panahon na niya
ako na, sa kayang na-mention, si Wiska, atong CIDG region, o Colonel Banson? Mo na iyahan nga ko ah. Na-mention.
Ito siya may tuyuan yung mga tabang mo. Oo. Yung mga tabang kinsa ang
tuyuan yung mga tabang. Oo, nangayong tabang ni Colonel Banson na sir, o mahin mo sir, mauli ang akong bana, gahapon ang kanagawa ng gano'n. Nangay po tabang ni General Gamboa, General Isar, General Pasculan. Oh, nagkaroon ka rin niya.
So we're about siya naman?
Sa akong bala ka ron? Akong ituhan, alas na may, alas pa nila. Or sa marami na guy.
Ano sa'yo na sa'yo?
Maka-text naman siya, pero dili na mong kumusalig nga insak mo ako na iyang istorya. Kay adto og NCR, ano na ako Cebu. Kaya sa ako na ibanaan ng yun, sa kadugay sa servisyo sa akong bana, og i-reassign, pero siya may madto. Anong kaming may sitwasyon karon, anong gisundo man siya og sa ka-opisyal? Anong nalipog ko, nga no? Nga nung gisundo siya sa opisyal, Nang ano na meeting previous, nang ipasaligan siya na inalify, na
Imuon
siya. Imuon siya sa fitness. Diya nagdag ko na pati na siya pagka naduna na dito ko. Nga politika ni ang polis gidamay sa politika.
Sa pamilya mo na until na napa siya sa servisyo o
Nakapa siya kay wala pa siya papirma. Ang ako tang gusto mong itago ganihan parang adawa. Papirmahon na ako siya resignation letter. Unyan kay ang supposedly ang mga dito sa laho na abogado nga kung ihangyan yung taong nga, sir, tabangin yung taong patrili, tabangin yung taong patrili nga kanang makapirma resignation. Kaya officially resign siya, hindi na papubos ang PNP niyang asa siya dalon. Nya kay wala man siya papirma, so ni anak siya, anak ni nakatexto man siya na ako nga, mamo, mangukoy, mangyipumang kay, until ng PNP pa mangukoy, under pa ko sa PNP. Pero ni sent ko letter ni General Gamboa, General Kaskulan, General Rizar, nga sir, ang akong intention is sulat ko ang letter nga paundang na ako pagpapulis, pagpamulis akong bana, kay ano lang binuhuli na ako mga bugi.
Ma'am, wala ba mo patabang sa human rights?
Nagpatabang sa human rights, sir, sa Cebu. Munang i-acto ang human rights gahapon sa CP, asa na, PC Hills, na ho, gi-deny nila ang akong bana na wala ko na dito. I'm sure po, he is with Colonel Garzon.
Sir, pamatay niyo naman ang gi-deny.
Muna, ano mang gi-deny?
Pa sa service.
Manaka man sila, ditaman dyan siya, sure mang yung manaka siya, kaya ni-studio naman siya na ako sa PC Hills, Laho.
Patong-patong noon din ka, nakakalang pa siya sa service. Yung may sinako sa service, na i-chapa, na i-pistula, na i-armas, kompleto pa siya.
Naka siya sa service, pero gikwaan siya o ganiha, o gikwaan siya na o armas ganiha. Ingat po, babe, sa istorya na.
Siya, rason ba?
Aron ko nang dilik siya mag-maburong. Sir, di kayo ko mag-maburong. Sir, sir.
Dapat sa mga human rights, it's a pamanyahan yung dilik lang mo di kayo lang ligamitan na ipasalit o reaction.
Sa katakakong ipang Texan, wala may nireply, pero basta naman ni reaction na sila na wala din necessary na mag-reply sila ako. Pero wala mo budbud sa nireply. Ang take action na gidayon is ang CHR. Ang CHR. Take action nga. Ipatabang ko nila. Nga ila. Ang ako hindi ganyan gusto nga. Ma-rescue dito ta siya.
Mayor Janice.
Wala ka nagigit salig.
Siguro, ang gusto nilang palabas na talagang nag-complain itong pamilya ni Police Master Sergeant Pinero, bakit i-transfer siya sa Manila? That's, yan ang pinaka main thought of the whole video. Am I correct? Para makasimte ng time. Kasi Oo. Yung iba rin hindi nakaintindi dahil Bisaya eh. Oo. Yung iba na kaganoon lang ko, hindi nila alam kung ano yung pinagsasabi. So, pinaka main thought doon is that. Correct ako?
Yung tin-transfer siya at yung pipilitin siya to sign documents pointing to the governor as mastermind. Parang more or less, sinabi niya kung sino yung mga tao doon. Pero okay. It's okay. We can move to the next slide, Mr. Chair.
So, i-forward na natin.
Para, yes. Ito'y last. Ay, sorry. Ay. So that is the last slide, sir. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Sandali ha, Tomasino Alidro. We have an information coming from NBI that Alidro Tomasino departed March 10, 2023, Naya 2, PR310 for Hong Kong. So as of now, hindi pa ito bumalik from Hong Kong. Pero sige lang, pagpapatulong tayo kay Mr. Henry Tevez, baka makontak mo kung andito lang pumuntahin dito. Police Colonel Romel Ochabe. Saan ito siya? Andito?
PD Cebu, sir.
As of now?
Yes, sir.
Police Colonel Tolentino. PD Aklan. Chief Police Lieutenant Colonel Ariel Huisca.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, the said police officer is currently at the PHAW of CIDG. And he just texts me and he is manifesting that he be invited to the this hearing so that he can reveal some things.
Thank you. Very good. Yan ay snappy. Mag-volunteer na maimbitahan para to clear everything. Police Colonel Arnel Banson. Saan ito siya ngayon?
Sir, he's currently assigned as our RSSG, sir, in PRO 7 headquarters, sir.
PRO 7?
Yes, po, sir.
Next hearing, imbitahan natin ito. Kasi pinangalanan sila dito. Okay. Tapos na, Mayor Janice? Okay na? Sige, thank you. From here, we shift our attention to the presentation from DOJ regarding the updates of these cases, particularly those cases na tinakil natin kahapon. So, Yusik, GC Hermoines Andres, Senator Tolentino, you have the floor.
Pwede po bang malaman sa DOJ, ganong katagal itong presentation nyo? Case specific, tapos yung usapan po kahapon, ito turnover na yun yung folder dito sa committee secretary. Ganong katagal po ito?
It will depend, Your Honor, on whether the committee members would have questions. But what we intend to present is simply the matrix of the cases filed within the region, identifying the victims, identifying who are the accused in the case, and stating the status report of each individual case that is already filed in court.
Sige po, kahit hindi mo na kami magtanong, tuloy-tuloy niyo lang po yan.
That's your pleasure, Your Honor.
Thank you, Yusek. Mr. Mr. Chairman, perhaps they can proceed.
Yeah, you can proceed now. You have the
Your Honor, for the better enlightenment of the committee, allow me to take up some preliminary matters, Your Honor. We have already submitted before this honorable committee a copy of our updated status on the Digamo cases, which is dated April 11, 2023. And this is a 22-page...
Yusek, I just would like to remind you, wala pa kami kopya, ha? Makasabi mo, submitted to this committee.
Isasubmit
mo yan afterwards.
There is also a hard copy there. There's also a soft copy.
Sige, thank you. Please continue.
Chairman, pwede ba palakihin to? Medyo hindi na makita.
The eyes of Senator Tolentino is not as sharp as mine. Please expand the font. Yan, kita mo?
We will discuss this case shortly, Your Honor. But allow me, Your Honor, to discuss some preliminary matters for orderly discussion before the committee. As I said, there is a memo dated April 11, 2023, which informs this committee of the suspects in all of the cases filed regarding the Digamo murder, including those killed on the same day on March 4 together with Governor Digamo. And there are 11 suspects involved in these cases, and the respective statuses will also be stated. Likewise, in the previous committee meeting, Your Honor, this committee requested the Department of Justice to create a task force so that these cases, the several related cases, or cases which were of a similar nature, politically colored cases, be decided not necessarily within the prosecution office in Negros Oriental, but by a different task force. And the Secretary of Justice has already directed us to do so and to create a task force that will handle all these political killings. All in all, we have 23 cases
Thank you.
Presently.
Thank you.
Yeah, but just to clarify.
Thank you for that move. Salamat. Pakisabi kay Secretary Remulla. Thank you for acceding to our request.
And we will make sure that there is no miscarriage of justice. For the convenience of the witnesses and the complainants, it is possible that we will hold the task force hearings even within Region 7 in Cebu, or depending on the request of the witnesses, whether they want to go to Manila. But we will provide the venue in Cebu, which is still within Region 7, in accordance with our rules in the DOJ, where there are cases that cannot be handled directly by the Provincial Prosecution Office, which has jurisdiction. It can be transferred to the nearest Provincial Prosecution or Regional Prosecution Office within the region for their own convenience. Okay. So likewise, may it please this committee to be informed that the several witnesses who were presented before this committee were already assisted by the WPP or the Witness Protection Program. The committee referred to us several of those who testified before this committee, and we were able to talk to at least three of them already. And the Witness Protection Program Director is already discussing the procedures for their formal admission into the program so that they can be properly given assistance and the security protection. So now, with respect to the directive of this committee for us to prepare a status, we have in right now here a matrix of all the cases. We have here, as of April 15, 2023, 23 cases. We call it political killings or assassinations, and we classify this as politically colored because the victims are either newsmen. We have here some councilors, kagawad. We have here board members or some barangay captains who were killed during this period, mostly between 2019 to 2023. And there is also one incident in 2007. So the places that where these criminal acts were committed include the city of Baiz, Bayawan, Canlaon, Dumaguete, Ginhulgan, and Negros proper, Your Honor. So we are forwarding to this committee 16 folders, complete folders. These are hard copies of all the of the entire case folder involving these cases, which are mostly murder, multiple murder, Your Honor, and frustrated and attempted murder. Out of these 23 cases, all of them have already been filed in court, meaning that the Department of Justice has found probable cause against the accused, and they will all be held for trial for murder, for frustrated murder, attempted murder, as the case may be, except for three instances where the cases were dismissed. And I would like to mention this, where the victim is Generoso, the radio announcer, Your Honor. The case was dismissed because the accused, the respondent there, also died, and the criminal liability is extinguished with the death of the respondent, Your Honor. And there are two cases also similarly, and one case referring to the victim Dungog, Miguel Lopez Dungog, who is a board member. This was archived because the accused could not be located. And there is an alias warrant of arrest issued, and the accused is presently at large. And finally, the case where the victim is Edmund Sestoso, where the murder case was likewise dismissed because of the withdrawal of the complaint by the wife, Lourdes G. Sestoso. Having said that, Your Honor, it is still possible to file the case and revive this case if there are witnesses willing to cooperate even with the withdrawal of the complaint by the wife. So with respect to the other cases, all of these cases are already resolved by the Department of Justice. The preliminary investigation and the inquest proceedings have all been terminated. And as I said, the Department of Justice found probable cause against the accused in all of these enumerated cases. And all of these cases now will be raffled off, and there will be warrants of arrest issued for the accused, respective accused in all of these cases. One case also is resolved by the Office of the Prosecutor General, and this refers to the murder also of Governor Degamo. And this will include now the additional respondents who were eventually arrested in the course of the hot pursuit. Earlier, we had four gunmen arrested, and they were already part of the inquest proceedings, and cases have been filed against them for murder. And the additional gunmen who were eventually arrested are now subject of these new cases that the Office of the Prosecutor General has decided. And this is also for filing murder and multiple murder and frustrated murder for the nine victims who died, and for the 17 others who were injured. Cases of frustrated murder and various degrees of physical injuries, cases were also filed against all the 11 accused before the proper courts, Your Honor. So likewise, we coordinated, Your Honor, with the PNP, because most of the cases that were discussed during the two committee hearings also involved cases which were not yet within the purview of the Department of Justice. The case has not been elevated to the prosecutors, and this is for still continuous case buildup before filing before the prosecutors. And I understand there are still 16 possible cases for filing which are presently being undergoing case buildup with the PNP. Maybe, Your Honor, it would be also timely to inform this committee of a department circular of the Department of Justice, which was recently issued, in fact, only in March 31. I gather in the discussions today and even yesterday that there are many gaps or many important matters falling within the cracks because of the lack of coordination between the law enforcement agents and the prosecutors. A lot of complaints are not being properly pursued. There's no follow-through work because there is no mechanism where the prosecutors could properly guide and make the follow-through work with the law enforcement agents. And precisely the recent circular, Department Circular Number 20, signed by Secretary Remulla, addresses this proactive coordination between the prosecutors and elites.
Can this committee be furnished a copy of that recently released circular coming from Secretary Remulla? And my number two question, this is important. Will that committee exist for how long? 2 years, 3 years, or till the termination of all the cases that you just mentioned?
Your Honor,
the lifespan.
The department circular does not really pertain specifically to the Degamo cases.
Yes, we're referring to the 23 cases.
Oh, yes, Your Honor.
Yes. So how long will that task force exist? Kasi papalit-palit yung ibang piskal, hindi na alam. Ito na lang ba yung talaga nakatutok doon hanggang matapos itong 23?
Yes, Your Honor. We will devote a specific pool of prosecutors to handle all of these cases. Probably a group of 5 prosecutors who will continue to see the prosecution of this case up to its logical conclusion, not only with respect to the preliminary investigation, but even to the conduct of the trial proper. for all of these cases. This is our, our insight where we cannot allow the cases to be transferred to people who do not have any idea of the case buildup. We want those who are part of the case buildup to actively prosecute and participate in the conduct of the trial.
In that case, Mr. Chairman, to ensure the sustainability and existence of this task force, perhaps during the budget hearing, we can include a provision specifically specifying this task force and allocating a continuous separate funding resource to ensure your existence in Region 7.
That would be most welcome.
Thank you,
Your Honor. That would Thank be you. Most but, helpful.
Ensure this committee that you will perform all of this that you promised.
We will, Your Honor. Thank you. The motto of our department, Your Honor, is justice for all, compassionate justice, and we do not want to lose any case. That is the concept of the case build-up.
Thank you.
We
thank
will
you.
File solid cases to make sure that there is a reasonable certainty of conviction for all cases filed in court.
Thank you. Please proceed. Thank you, Your Honor.
Be sure to remind Senator Tolentino of his commitment during the budget hearing. Ha? Pakipalo-up lang. Baka makalimutan niya yan. He will be handling the DOJ budget, so paki-remind.
That's most appreciated, Your Honor.
And Yusik Andres, I'm really happy with that new circular na sinasabi mo na magkakaroon ng tulungan yung prosecutor at saka yung police investigators. Kasi alam namin, kami sa police, nag-retire lang ako sa police, ganito palaging tingin ko eh. And my question is like this. Forgive me for my question. Ako isang ordinaryong police lang. Kikita ko. Sabi ko, ano ba itong DOJ? Pareho kaming nasa executive branch of government. Ang PNP, under sa DILJ. Ang prosecution, under sa DOJ. We are all under the executive branch of government. Nakikita ko kasi sa mga sine, na yung mga police doon at saka yung sinasabi natin district attorney ay halos sila nakipagbabarilan doon sa mga kriminal, nagsama-sama sila doon pag imbestiga ng kaso. So nakita ko dito sa amin, hanggang sa nag-retire ako, nakita ko para man kaming hindi pariyong taga-executive branch of government na hindi magtutulungan. Kasi ang tingin namin sa prosecution, once nag-file kami yung police ng kaso sa prosecution, ang feeling ng prosecution, mataas sila sa amin. In fact, kung tutuusin, we are only equal pillar in the criminal justice system, di ba? Para ang tingin ng mga piskal, porque mga abogado sila, kami mga police investigator lang sa baba, pag-submit namin ang kaso, pag-file ang kaso, sabi kagad ng piskal, mali ito, dismiss. Mali itong ginagawa nyo, dismiss. Para bang hindi mo lang kami bigyan ng chance o kaya tulungan na mapaganda yung aming kaso. Dapat ganun dapat ang attitude ng mga prosecutor natin. Oy, Sergeant, Sergeant to investigator, mali man itong ginawa mo, dapat ganito. So, advice nila na pareho lang naman, we're working under one government, under the executive branch of government. So, mali, dismiss. Wala man lang advice na tulungan ba?
Parang ganun. For the information of this committee, Honor, these reforms in our conduct of the criminal justice procedures
born out of the consultations with the Justice Sector Coordinating Council. This is composed of the Department of Justice, the Supreme Court, and the DILG. So with these three pillars working out an improvement in the conduct of our criminal justice procedures, these matters were pointed out, and without the proactive involvement of the prosecutors, there will be no effective criminal justice prosecution. So now there is the law enforcement agents now being partners with the prosecutors to solve a crime in the similar manner as the district attorneys are doing it in the American setting. Because that is the way we can declog our courts, and that is the way we can have less people, PDLs, in detention centers when we file only quality and solid cases based on a good case build-up.
Tama ka. Sana you're the next Secretary of Justice. pagdating ng araw para magandang takbo ng hustisya natin. Matutuwa itong mga pulis kapag ganun ang attitude ng DOJ.
Thank you.
Thank you. Senator Tolentino, you have the floor.
Problema lang sa DOJ, ang daming prosecutors ngayon nag-file maging judge. Gusto na maging judge, kaya mababakante uli yung mga pwesto ng prosecutor. So, ang dami nyo namang itetrain uli, di ba?
You are right, Your Honor. Because
we turned away from the discussion, pero in the next 2 years, maraming magiging judge na. So, bakante na naman yun.
You're right, Your Honor, because the pay scale in the judiciary is much higher than the prosecutors. If we elevate the pay scale of the prosecutors also in the same level as the judges, then they will stay put with the DOJ.
Your Honor, Mr. Chairman, for the record.
Yes.
Nakakatuwa po, 43 PNP personnel passed the bar exams. Ang dami nun. So, yung mga bagong abogado ngayon ng Philippine National Police, pwede kayong, huwag na mo kayo mag-resign, baka mag-prosecutor kayo. So, we have now a contingent of legal minds coming from the PNP. 43. Hatiin natin yun by region. Ang dami nun, Mr. Chairman. Diba?
Marami yun.
Marami yun. 43 yun.
Sana huwag itong umalis sa PNP at magamit sila ng PNP. So, Mr. Tolentino, Senator Tolentino, can we proceed? Thank you.
We will formally turn over, Your Honor, these documents to the committee secretariat.
Yeah, please.
So that these folders, together with the soft copies, complete the 23 cases, Your Honor.
Thank you, Yusek Andres.
But we have printed only 16 complete case folders, but the soft copies completing the other 7 cases are also...
Can we be given a copy of the matrix that you abruptly terminated presenting?
Yes, hindi
naman, para may kopya lang kami. Doon sa 23 po na kaso, madalian lang po ito, marami nakikinig. Ilan na naka-file? Ilan na na-dismiss? Ilan ang pending? May ilan ang ipa-file pa? Mabilisan lang po.
20 cases already in court, Your Honor. 3 have been dismissed, 2 have been dismissed, and 1 is archived for failure to serve the warrant of arrest. So 20 active cases are now being pursued in court in relation to all the political killings in the area, Your Honor.
And please constantly update this committee, yung magiging output ng task force na gagawin ninyo.
We can do that.
Yes, please. Thank you.